Alright, this episode is going to be titled, What the Fuck? This was probably the worst recording session that we had. So you'll see some stuff that happened in this episode. Like you'll see we had chips on the screen, and then all of a sudden it will go through and cut to a different look and feel of the video. Because OBS Studio was giving us all sorts of problems the day that we recorded this. You'll notice that LP was even more frustrated than normal. So, bear with us. This is we rescued what we could of this recording, and we wanted to get this out here to you guys. So, enjoy what we were able to go through and rescue.
This video contains adults playing X-Wing miniatures. Adult language is used. You have been warned. Welcome, everybody, to the latest Central Ohio X-Wing game commentary. I am one of your hosts today. You can call me LP. I also go by L. Parker Gibson, or Parker, or that fucking asshole. Joining us today, we have our first game participant with me, Bryan Keller. Say hi, Bryan.
Hi. How's it going?
We're doing well, thanks. I'm just going to make him try and sit here and be awkward and chuckle. And also, Hassan Khan. Say hi.
Hello.
Hello. Excellent. And our master behind the keyboard, the baiter of all things good and kind in the world, we have Dave Carver. Say hi, Dave.
Hello. Also known as the Bomber Guy.
El Bomberino.
Yes.
The Bomber Master. The Bombmeister.
Yes. Pay no attention to the man behind the curtain.
Yes. He is officially the man behind the curtain today. And sitting here in the audience today, joining us for a game at another time, we have Weston Thobabin. Weston, wave hi to everybody. That's right. You can't see him because he's not on camera, but he is waving. He's also taking his shirt off.
Oh, man.
So let's go ahead and roll this out. You heard our fantastic intro music by Ben Sound today. And here is Brian's first list. Check it out. We've got a Lothal Rebel with FCS, Auto Blaster Turret, Harrison Doula and Chopper, and three motherfucking Snap Crackle Pop Rice Krispie A-Wings.
The best A-Wings.
They're so good. I love them. They're so amazing. Anyway, that comes in at a flat 100. And today, this is my list. A pair of Lothal Rebels with accurate auto blaster turrets, one with the chopper crew, and my own version of the A-Wing, which you'll find out sucks.
Right, because Parker hates rolling dice.
I hate dice. I hate dice so bad. But I have crack shot and trick shot because I want to take the chance to be able to shoot things from a distance. You'll find out, spoiler alert, it didn't work. So, A-Wing test pilot, chard and refit, you know the deal. But auto thrusters to try and live longer. It didn't work. So let's go ahead and roll right into our game for it. Before getting their ass whipped, spoiler alert. And you'll see that we are about ready to get rolling. And of course, I fly my A-Wing out straight. And you're going to notice something here. Once the movement gets done, you're going to notice what ends up happening. But one thing that we talked about, this is our second try, by the way, for those who aren't keeping track at home. We were sitting here trying to make this work. And we had this great commentary going. And all of a sudden, beds were shit.
Hey.
It was truly like an old folks' home. Just everything went to hell in a handbasket.
There was smoke. There was fire. It was just dogs and cats were sleeping together.
Yeah, dogs and cats living together. Mm-hmm. Now, you'll notice that as I moved around, so like, check out the distance now between my A-Wing and my first Lothal Rebel. See how they're catty-cornered to each other instead of parallel? So that was just total screw-up on my part. They should have been parallel.
Okay, so we were trying, in the first one round, we were trying to talk about your rock placement and stuff.
Yeah.
And you said you like patterns.
Yeah, I mean, well, A, I like patterns. But I really do dig the idea of how rocks are set up because, as I've said at other times, and maybe you've heard me talk about this before, I'm still learning the game, even though I've been playing it since, what, I guess Wave 6 when Scum came out. Why I never stuck with frickin' robots, I'll never know. Why? Come on, what a hell of a list robots are, right?
Right.
But, so Brian's A-Wing's coming around the corner tight as hell.
Yeah. It looks like he's flown A-Wings before.
Yeah, it's like this isn't his first go-round. But yeah, that's such a great maneuver, because you got your A-Wings maneuvering around, you got a real tight formation.
Right, you get to five straight in the boost, and the next turn you can do a three, a four, or five straight, depending on how much of a turn you want.
That's so good.
To get in.
Because basically, then you could set yourself up with, like, you go from that position in the back to almost like line abreast coming around. It's
right.
Really nice.
Right, and with all the rocks near me, I just fly by them all so they don't bust up the formation at all.
Yeah, so once you get to this point, because considering the rocks the way they are, shaped in the stupid fucking pyramid that I made, what's your next, what are you planning next for your moves here?
Well, I'm trying to get to the side of your either ghost. I'm not sure how far you're going to move, if you're going to go one straight or really come up behind me. So I'm looking to get my A-wings facing our direction now. So I need to go straight and then do a boost.
Yeah.
So I need to go far enough with that, a measuring distance basically with that back A-wing so he doesn't run into that debris.
Sure.
So it's going to be like a 4-straight or a 5-straight plus a boost, and then I can start shooting your ship.
So hindsight being 50-50 or 20-20 or whatever that stupid fucking phrase is, I really feel like what I should have done here was too hard at the ghosts.
Yeah, if you turn at my A-wings, I've got a big problem.
Yeah, I should have at this point too hard at the ghosts, and then I don't know if a 3-hard would have fit with that A-wing, with that debris where it was. A 3-hard might fit, but 3-hard and boost up. That's what I should have done. Because that would have basically clobbered you up, no action, just sitting there going, well, I did not mean to jog him so hard, Indigo.
Right, and then if I get close to you, you get an automatic 2 damage on my 4 health ships.
Yeah.
So I have to start breaking formation and flying past you to not take that damage.
Yeah. A-wings definitely do not want to joust with, you know, 4 attack die ghosts that also have auto blaster turrets.
Yeah, see, it's just one of those things where, because I've flown against A-wings before, but I flew against A-wings with more fragile ships. I forgot how to fly ghosts, basically. I should have said, wait a minute, ghosts, duh. Okay, run me over, please, Mr. A-wing.
Well, normally, I'm not too upset to joust with a 1 agility ship because I have snapshots, so I get 2 attacks a turn.
Right.
But, again, accuracy corrector auto blaster is going to destroy me, so I can't really use snapshot much this round, this game.
That was basically it. Because I think what ended up happening was you managed to, you're going to, like, we'll see as the game goes, but you managed to stay right around range 2 of one of the ghosts and then is off angle, so I couldn't really get a shot at you. I mean, there's a reason to mount the shuttle onto a ghost because you get that extra back arc as a primary weapon arc.
And the double tap.
And you get the double tap turret. I mean, there is merit to that. Because you can actually still, I mean, there are lists where you can run 2 ghosts, one of which has the Phantom shuttles docked on it. I think you have to do it with Zeb's shuttle, and Zeb's shuttle has nothing on it.
I think so, yeah.
But you could still have a double accurate ghost auto blaster turret with 4 dice out the front and 4 dice out the back, and still have enough room for another ghost.
Yeah, it looks like those A-wings are starting to come in hot and heavy here.
Oh, yeah. Here goes Dave trying to bring normalcy back to the podcast discussion.
Sorry, I guess like there's the action.
Ah, shit. No, I'm not dying yet. Man. There's no action.
Getting right up behind the ghost.
So you did move up a lot farther than I thought you were, but it works out because I'll just target the back one, and unless you 5K, he's really not going to be
And you'll notice my positioning, 5K would have rocked me.
Yeah.
And I think 5K, maybe I did 5K here, and it rocks me.
So as long as Bryan stays at roughly range 2 with his A-wings, he's in prime position to
just
shoot up the ghosts and not worry about any auto blaster turrets or anything.
Yeah, totally. And I think, did that catch the corner?
I don't remember.
Yeah, I think it was real close. It caught the corner of the rock, or it was just right off the rock. So either way, I mean, yeah, this was just, this was a Hawaiian dicking. As the game goes on, you'll see that I just slowly but surely melt to pieces. Wow, I feel like I've just basically given away the whole result of the game as we're sitting here talking about it. But because my goals were originally go after that ghost in the back. But then again, I guess that's because I took the obvious bait. Because I figured, shit, that's going to be the scary thing to me. But keep in mind, so Brian's ghost has Hera crew and Chopper crew with FCS on it and the auto blaster.
So he's basically like a defender, just 4K or 5K, 5K, 5K.
Yeah, and he's always going to get a target lock action because wherever he shot, he's going to target lock. So it's brutal.
So my plan here is for the ghost just to suck up as much damage as possible.
And it did.
Hopefully trade 1 ghost for 1 ghost, maybe dig into the second ghost while my first ghost is there with the help of the A-wings.
Yeah.
And then I think at that point, my plan was to have maybe 2 A-wings versus your 1 A-wing or maybe just 1-on-1.
Yeah. And it was, and the video has gone crazy.
Oh, keep going.
We've gone to plaid, ladies and gentlemen. But
we got the fog of war.
At this point, he's firing. I think you were firing.
Yeah, this is from the ghost, so I missed that rock.
Yeah.
So we got some ghost on ghost action, look like?
Some, whatever.
Yeah, firing at that bat ghost.
Yeah. He had four dice against my two dice because of range three.
Range three through a rock. Don't see a ghost rolling two green dice very often.
Makes you feel fun when it happens, though. Man, makes me want to put stealth device and countermeasures on one.
Stealth device, countermeasures. What else can you do? Oh, man.
Yeah, unfortunately, you can't.
Have another ghost with tack jammer.
That'd be amazing. Three dice ghost. It's like, get past that, fools. But yeah, it's like, hey, guess what? I lose some more shields. What do you know? I'm playing ghosts. My shields go away.
Yeah, it looks like the back ghost is running pretty low on shields. Looks like you got maybe one or two left there.
Yeah, I mean, he was more or less, he was just powerfully fucked right there. And so we were checking, we were basically checking range at that point to see if that back A-wing could fire at the ghost.
It was close.
Yeah, literally it was off by like a mil.
Looks like it's out, just barely. Not too bad, but this time, you know, next round you can maybe like 5K or turn in and, you know, get some shots back.
Yeah, but I think that we're going to find out here that when I 5K, I'm literally just clipping the rock. I think that's what ends up happening, but we'll see. Because once again, like when I broadcast, I remember nothing of these games. So it's like me, pay attention to what I do.
To be fair, it's a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, you just make it up as you go along anyways.
Absolutely. That's the story of my life. Yeah, so now we're in the gentle plotting phase. Now, if I recall, and honestly I don't, I think that my goal here was to whip the A-Wing around and go do something funky with it. And then whip this the first ghost around. I may have even thought about 5K-ing that ghost. Because like a 5K with that ghost would have probably barely cleared the rock.
Yeah, the back one is close.
Yeah, the front one I'm pretty sure would clear the rock.
Front one for sure clears the rock, yeah.
I think I might take damage from the rock.
I mean, it's whatever. You're flying a ghost.
Oh, shucks, I took a shield damage. And you're going to see one of them has a focus token stuck in the side of it, and that's the ghost that actually has the chopper crew on it. I just did that just to mark them differently. I didn't feel like dragging up my numbers, and quite frankly, I have no idea where they are. Just because I own so much X-Wing crap that just you lose track of it.
So, Parker, your A-Wing has trick shot, crack shot, and auto thrusters.
Yeah, I went auto thrusters for survivability. And I like trick shot because I figured that I'm probably going to have shots through debris. And why not roll an extra die? Because statistically, you've got a 12.5% greater chance to hit with that extra die.
That's right. Trick shots, of course, a new EPT that came out with Heroes of the Resistance.
Uh-huh.
Roll one additional die if the attack is obstructed.
Yep.
It's a nice little alternative 0-point EPT. Finds A-Wings, but in grand scheme of things.
Okay, so I'm trying to figure out. I think first I'm playing around with my phone, trying to basically text my wife and say, honey, I'm on the way home soon, getting my shit pushed in really hard, about to die, love you, give my love to the cats.
Well, you're waiting for me to take like 5 minutes to figure out my move.
Yeah, well, that's okay, because you were trying to figure out the best way to stick it in my pooper, and I am doing my best to say, hey, I already know what I'm going to do, and I'm sure it's wrong, but again, probably wanted to... I can't remember what I was supposed to do here, but my thought was I'm pretty sure that I either want a hard turn or 5K or hard turn or K turn the A-wing, hard turn or K turn the ghost front, and then soft turn the ghost there, and then we'll see what I actually do. So I think I one hearted here.
Yes. That is indeed a one hard.
Yes. So I turn around one hard so I can kind of loop the ghost around or loop the A-wing around, because I can boost here and get a funky shot. If I'm feeling fresh, and I think it's exactly what I did, yeah.
Feeling quite fresh, it looks like.
Yes, I'm quite funky fresh, as the A-Wings are wont to do. Now, let's see what this guy's doing. And...
I'm expecting a 5K?
No, I think I two-hearted.
Ooh.
It's a one turn.
One-hearted with stress, yeah, that's right.
That is not what I expected.
That's actually
a good move. I like it.
I'm really good at doing things that people don't expect, just sometimes doesn't work. And that's probably because I have an incredibly poor grasp of the game at times. Because I thought at this point, I need to get back into this game. I need to try and get an angle back around. I need to find a way to get my face stuck back in. But really, I should have done these things a turn ago. I should have hard turned in a turn ago instead of now trying to come around and figure things out.
Were you thinking about chopper there? Is that what that was?
Yeah, I think I choppered.
Okay.
I took a damage because he hadn't taken damage yet. I took a damage to take an action and then ghosted.
Looks like we have a 5K from the rear ghost.
Yep, and then I think that rocked. So just like I talked about, it was really close to rocking, and of course, what did I do? I rocked. And of course, I did damage to myself.
Oh, that's rough.
Problems.
Shield's down on that ghost now.
Yeah. No shield, Willie. But I'm in a good position. Now, if I hadn't rocked here, mother of pearl would things have been sexy.
Now, was that your rock or was that Brian's rock?
That was my first rock.
So that rock is definitely on your team.
Yeah, that rock, that is a Team Brian rock.
Okay, so I go straight here because if I bank, I might get into range one,
and then all of a sudden you're in Astro Blaster range.
Right.
Asshole Blasters. I'm going to start calling them Asshole Blasters. Accurate Auto Blasters are now Astro Blasters. Asshole Blasters. There we go. Works perfect.
Well, they can blast from any side, though.
True. But in particular, Accurate Auto Blasters are, I don't roll dice, you take 2 damage, except me.
Yep.
Present them. So Brian, of course, is going, one straight turn in. Now, if that ghost hadn't rocked, shit, would I have some shots. But what did I do?
Oh, yeah.
I rocked, because I'm an idiot.
Brian's taking the opportunity to just turn his A-wings in now that the other ghost.
If I had two-hearted here,
that'd be even.
Think about the nastiness that would be happening right now. He'd be bumping some, and I'd be accurate auto-blasting the dude in the back.
That is prime auto-blaster range. And look at this. We got ghost-on-ghost action.
Yeah, I think our ghost-on-ghost did a whole, like a hot renegade there. I think did you rock yourself?
Yeah, I'm on that debris.
Yeah, so I think you.
I mean, I have hair crew. I really don't care.
Yeah, because it's real simple. It's a goddamn ghost, and it doesn't care. Yeah, I need to start bringing 3 debris fields if I'm running ghosts, just because I don't really care.
Debris is best for ghosts, because you can just land on debris and just not care.
Yep. So, I took a stress. Hoop-de-doo.
Especially with Hera crew.
Oh, yeah. You just keep so good.
K-turning over it and just doesn't
matter.
Oh, double
stress? I don't care. Hera chopper. So one of my ghosts I'm looking at for the future, building it out just like Brian's, because they're both 40 points.
Mm-hmm.
But so instead of accurate auto blaster, it turns into FCS auto blaster with Hera chopper crew.
And we got shots coming in from Parker.
Yeah.
That was 5 sexy. Dice range one into Brian's ghost.
And I think I did 4 hits or something like that.
Yeah, so no need for extra corrector.
Yeah, I used my focus. So stripped off 4 shields, made me feel better about myself. That's the only damage I really did that turn.
The good use of chopper.
Yeah.
Because I don't remember how many focus results you had there, but you definitely had to spend your focus.
Yeah, trading 1 shield on your ghost for 4 on his is pretty good.
Yeah.
Range 2 shot for my guy.
It was range 2 because of that action, right? And there's your FCS that went off. Oh, you were shooting at the back ghost, yeah.
Yeah.
Yep, the damage one.
Just chewing up that one more.
Looks like you have to shuffle your damage deck first.
Yeah, because of course I don't shuffle my fucking damage deck in the beginning of the game like a winner. So I'm going to pardon me while I shuffle my damage deck. Let's see, here's 1.
Take 1, 2, 3
damage. Hooey.
That's not terrible.
So now I'm sitting on 7 damage to go. But the thing is I don't have any return shots. It's like, shit.
And here come the A-Wings.
Yeah, so range 3 coming in. I get 1 whole dodge die.
It looks like they're just missing.
Missed. I missed both shots, yeah.
I think you whiffed really hard with them this turn. It's like your dice sort of went cold on you.
Yeah, A-Wings just do that sometimes, you know.
But I think that guy, yeah, and then you cracked it off.
Did you roll a natural evade there?
I think I did.
Yeah, he did. I crossed
that's depressing.
It was 1-1, he cracked it. And it was a crit.
Crit.
He cracked it.
Do we know what the crit is?
Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter, I lost. So, see how easy that was. Spoiler alert, I lost. But, at this point, things are looking really grim. I'm down to, I think it might have been direct hit, because there was a direct hit on that ghost at one point. So now I'm down, I've got no return shots. I'm trying to figure out where the shit do I go next, and how do I take this on? Now, at this point, I'm legit confused, because, I mean, the thing with my chopper crew is now I'm sitting there stressed. This would have been a great time for a K turn, but the problem is technically a 5K would have parked me on that other fucking rock, and that would have been really bad. So, I mean, K turn doesn't work anyway. I think I may have one straighted. But so if we're looking at this here, because I've got a stressed ghost on a rock, so I can one straight, I can, what is it? On a ghost, is 1 straight green or is it 2 straight?
I think ghost has one straight green, maybe?
And then two straight
two
green
straight,
and two
straight, two bank.
Greens. Yeah, so I think I two softed here.
So,
but...
The problem is, of course, snapshot.
Yeah.
If you park in range one of those AoEs, you're going to take a lot of damage.
They're going to shred me. It's going to be like freaking cabbage.
I mean, best case scenario for you might be to just three bank and try to bump one of the A-wings and take only two snapshots.
Yeah.
It's really tough. Because, I mean, you do move first, so you get to choose, like, what happens there.
Yeah, choose my poison, yeah.
And if you do bump one of them, you could potentially bump the whole swarm and then get in prime autoblaster range. You know, maybe take down an A-wing before your ghost dies.
Yeah, which I think my ghost just snivels and dies, really. I mean, just I flew it very poorly in this game. But so the plan is I'm trying to figure out exactly where I need to go. Because I've got that A-wing. You can't see the A-wing because it's covered by the hull of the ghost again. So I got that A-wing up in front. And I think that, I mean, my options are potentially K-turn the A-wing because it's sitting there no stress. And if I K-turn the A-wing through the debris field in front of me, because he's sitting at an angle, so if I K-turn that A-wing, I'm going to end up on the debris field that's right behind Brian's ghost. So I do that, and all of a sudden, hey, now I get my trick shot to kick in. And I'm pretty sure that's what ends up happening.
So I think I took so long thinking about this, again, trying to stay out of range one of mm-hmm. all the possible locations your ghosts could be in.
Yeah.
That is the benefit of moving first for Parker.
Right.
Yeah, and then you had dropped the dial, but I wasn't looking at all. So it's like, as you can tell, because I still lost. But, so I was still trying to set
I'm really curious to see what this rear ghost does.
Fails, I think, but otherwise tries his hardest.
I love to see him just try to jam up the A-wing
so
formation
the K,
as
the
much
K-turn
as possible.
Coming in. I went 5K. I thought about a 3K, but I 5K'd and did not rock myself. And so now I'm sitting on double stress because it's a debris field, not an asteroid. But at the same time, I don't care because I have trick shot.
And, you know, you're an A-wing. You got range 3 auto thrusters. You got plenty of green maneuvers.
Yeah, that was my plan, was just that I'll park in the back. I have a good time. It's okay. So then I think I bumped here.
So oh, man. A 2-bank.
Yeah, because I was trying to get rid of a stress because of the 1 hard from previous turn.
Just ghost bumping ghosts. This is fun.
It's very spoopy. So I kind of slide in there, and it just barely caught the corner. Which, of course, was enough. But, I mean, that's fine. I got rid of my stress. And now I can turn around and potentially auto-blast or anything that gets within get-fucked range. And otherwise, I'm just kind of in a position where I can K-turn next turn. So now this ghost comes in. I think a 2-softed. I'm not quite 100% sure. We'll find out.
Yeah, 2-soft. You're going to be taking a lot of snapshots.
Which I'm pretty sure I did. Because I was just trying to clear out my
too soft.
Just trying to clear stress. So. Now, did you take the snapshots here? I can't remember.
I don't remember either.
So yeah. The front guy definitely has a snapshot. The rear one might not. It's hard to tell.
Yeah.
And I think
I don't think he took the snapshots here. And it's just, I mean, because I forgot about it too. So you remember when it was time for my A-wing to come out? And you fucked my A-wing straight up. But, no, because, like, right here, I mean, I'm not in such a terrible position, but I think what you did was just you K-turned.
Oh, wow, yeah. So, no snapshots.
Yeah.
Yeah, otherwise, that would have been an extra probably 3 damage I would have taken.
Yeah, I mean, it's unmodified, so, you know, anything could really happen.
But I think you're just outside of range 1 from me there, so I can't shoot you. Because this is where things really went bad for me. So, I'm sitting there, I'm just trying to, I should have probably gone 1 straight. If I'd have gone 1 straight, that would have screwed him up like crazy.
That's true. Yeah, 1 straight would have actually been pretty nice here.
That would have jacked his...
Especially where this ghost is going now.
Yeah. Because he K-turned that ghost. Literally everything.
Wow,
just,
that is...
That the is 1 some, straight would have been the better maneuver.
That's some prime flying.
Yeah, just completely read me like a book there. He knew exactly what I was going to do.
I mean, just the positioning with the K-turn with the A-wing and the K-turn with the ghost, it's so close together.
So good. It was really, really good.
Because if that ghost bumped that A-wing, everything would have just been jammed up. And Brian's ghost would have been out of position for a couple turns.
Yeah, and stressed. But he's got
yeah,
hair.
He can one hard, but...
He can just 1 hard, 3 hard, whatever. As if he really needs the action, he can just chopper it.
Yeah. Well, it looks like he did bump a couple of his A-wings there.
Yeah, I think I got a bump on one of the A-wings. Yeah,
it's like one or two of them at least.
Yeah. But I'm sitting in like prime ghosty boasty range.
If you can survive this round with the ghost, then you can 5K next round and, you know, finally get a shot.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I didn't though. Because I think both of those ghosts, both of those A-wings bump my ghost. Does that sound familiar, Bryan?
Yeah, it does.
Yeah, because both of them bumped. But honestly, again, if you'd remembered Snapshot there, then I'd be another 3 or 4 damage down, which would put me at almost death range for this salvo, which meant that this salvo would have killed me, and I think not the following salvo. But it was just a feels bad man moment the whole way through. So you can see my A-wing sitting back there having a K turned around, and I've got a debris field in the way so I can turn around and get my trick shot to finally work. That felt good. So now we're just lining up shots. I'm going, well, this guy is going to go that way, and this is where I'm going to shoot this way.
So I think the A-wing was out of range one, or did you just put the accuracy corrector on the ghost? I don't remember.
No, he was outside of range one because I checked. I couldn't shoot the A-wing in the back.
So you corrected the ghost then?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
At least I got a shot. You know?
You did something.
Yeah. Take two more damage.
And then we're out of range one here, too.
Yeah. Because that ghost was just outside of range one. This guy had a range three shot, I think, through a rock, maybe.
It looks like Brian's ghost does have some hull damage on it.
I've gotten some hull in on it. Because, I mean, it was that accurate shot that put two hull on it.
The last turn, five dice attack.
Yeah, because that really just mulched the hell out of it.
So we got
two hits, three hits, and then I just say, pardon me, while I just add more dice to the pile.
So is that the
A-wing? That was the A-wing, yeah.
Yeah, that was the one
A-wing. Five,
the
5K
back.
A-wing.
Oh, is that range one?
No. Whoa.
Oh, I saw three dice.
Oh, you know what? I think that was it. It wasn't range one, but me in my disabled mental state thought I might as well at least get more damage on the ghost because it's more damage, and I can maybe get it towards half health.
I see.
And get the points.
I see.
But even though this isn't really for points, and technically the A-wing would have been the better shot because I'm chewing up 50% of its capability, I figured it's a
and
agility
the
three.
Ghost is now gone.
Yeah, he just nuked it because that's where the direct hit came in. Because I had one shot with it because it was the 5 dice from his ghost and the 3 dice from the A-wing. I had 8 more dice coming in and I only had like 6 defensive pool.
That's pretty rough. And now your other ghost is starting to take a little bit of damage.
Yeah.
So at this juncture, what's your plan? How do you get back into this game after losing a ghost?
Honestly, at this point, you don't.
I don't think I don't think it's as bad as you think it is.
I'm pretty sure it's.
I just need.
But no, I mean, technically, you're right. The game is not out of reach for me. But the way that I was flying and the position I was in meant that I was down so many turns.
Right, you need to kill my ghost before I can do too much more damage to your
second. If you just look at the situation, you know, okay, so you have one ghost and one A-wing versus one ghost and three A-wings. But Brian's ghost is way more damaged than your ghost. So it's actually not that bad.
Yeah, basically, I mean, his ghost has taken probably the equivalent of like 2 A-wings worth of damage, maybe 3 A-wings. Because he's taken 6 shields and we're 2 hull in. So he's taken about 8 damage. He's sitting at half health. So 2 good salvos on that ghost could potentially
dead.
Kill it.
Mm-hmm.
If I get a couple crits in, then it's pretty dead. And then, you know, a ghost and an A-wing versus 3 A-wings, it's an iffy game because the A-wings can dance around.
That's true.
And just basically always stay at range 2 and off arc against the ghost.
If you can control range enough and, you know, start, you know, bumping the A-wings a little bit, then, you know, you can somehow control the range enough so you always stay in range 1.
Yeah. But at this point, it's just starting to look pretty ugly because I'm trying to reposition the ghost to where I can just... I think I end up probably K-turning here because I soft turn in. I'm parked right behind this rock. I'm going to get a... I don't think I touched the rock, but at the same time...
Trying to make great use of trick shot.
Yeah, I'm trying to use that fucking trick shot is what I am. Because I could have barrel rolled out, but instead I focused up for the trick shot. Whether that was smart or not, I couldn't tell.
I mean, there is some merit to trick shotting when you're... You know, fighting a ghost, obviously.
Because
ghost, okay, it's going to roll 1 extra die, whatever.
Yeah, but I mean, it's like I get to roll 3 at range 3.
Right.
And if it's really silly, it gets to range 1, I get 4.
You know, 1 so extra red die is better than 1 extra green die in general.
Yeah, 12.5% better, as I might say.
Green dice suck.
They do. So yeah, I K-turned over the over that, and of course I did not, in this case, damage myself. So I'm sitting on, I think, double stress after the K-turn and debris field. So now I'm lined up. Now at this point, I'm feeling like, okay, I've gotten the range back open again. I have the ability to reposition. I have repositioned. I can bring it back to a joust, and then I've got shots at a couple of ships that can't hit me. Like, he's got that A-wing pointed in that direction. That could be a prime target. Then I think his other A-wings are kind of pointed around as well. He's got his ghost here and his A-wing there, so they've got to come in. But I've got a couple of shots at ships that can't shoot me back. Or I can shoot at the ghost and maybe try to take it off the board. So we'll end up seeing what happens.
Most of these maneuvers look weird because of what you did. But again, I'm trying to stay out of range one. I thought maybe you could move your A-wing to self-bump your ghost to keep him more in the middle of the board.
I had kind of considered
That's why I K-turned with that other A-wing, just
sure.
Get him out of there.
Well, that makes perfect sense. Because, I mean, that was one of the things that I had considered, was basically moving the A in such a way that I could always just try to maintain some semblance of center. Like, because if I move the ghost first here, then the ghost bumps the A,
mm-hmm.
and then stays at range one, then I can accurate the shit out of something.
But I really like Perkins positioning here now, because he's going to get some unmolested shots against Brian's ghost, which is exactly what he needs right now.
I've got lots of debris in the way, got some extra
I think you actually shoot at the A-wing here with your ghost.
I probably fucked up, yeah, sure.
Or we were out of range three, I don't remember.
It was real close, we'll find out. So I rolled, we'll just count the dice and we'll be able to tell who I shot, right?
Well,
so that's my
yeah.
ghost shooting four dice.
Four, and I've got four.
Yeah, so shooting the
three natural hits.
I think the ghost was at outside of range three.
So three natural hits is pretty good.
Yeah.
And
you had five.
I see some blanks.
So I think I maybe did a shield or two, maybe.
Oh, shield, two shields and a damage. So,
yeah, so I did
Brian
slip
just
them all
blanked
through.
Out.
Because I think I maybe actually did kill an A-wing this turn. But then it's the next turn where my A-wing just bed shits.
Wow.
So now I get three shots with the trick shot at his A-wing.
Yeah, this A-wing could just die.
And I got two. I spent the focus,
oh, okay.
Got two.
Yep.
Ooh, okay, so he needs...
He's got four.
Will that be enough? Nope.
And I popped it.
Yep.
And that's why they call them snap, crackle, pop A-wings.
Yeah, and here's the other fucked up part, was that you were parked on top of a rock.
Right.
Because I forgot about the rock part.
Right.
So
that one was just me screwing up. That one wasn't on purpose.
So, like, when somebody else fucks up, I can take advantage of it. But it's waiting for them to fuck up is the problem.
Back to what you said, though, with the snap crack A-wings, if I had auto thrusters there, that's two damage I don't take.
Right.
Yeah.
For sure. But now you've got one ghost and one A-wing versus one ghost and two A-wings, which is much better odds.
Yeah.
And then here's Parker's A-wing. Rolling some green dice.
Rolling some terrible green dice.
You got auto thrusters. Is it range two or three, though?
It's at range, I think it's range two.
It looks like range two because you only get the plus one evade from the obstruction.
Yeah, I think I managed to dodge shots coming in. I lost a shield.
Yeah, it's not bad.
So not too bad. Grant, all things considered. But then he's checking range there, getting ready to fire his 10 pounds of goat meat right in my face. Goat is something I can never really get a handle on. It's always too gristly.
I love goat. Mm-hmm. Goat is awesome.
Do you really like goat?
I do.
But is it like good tender goat?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
See, because I've always had a hard time finding good tender goat, because I always end up like with the real stringy bits and just the stringy. I've got a problem with consistency.
Oh, man, there's a...
Like, where can you get good goat around here?
There's a, I think, like a Caribbean place on Cleveland.
Oh,
it's really good.
Because there's a halal meats not too far down the road from us.
So do one damage to the A-wing.
Yeah, it looks like one damage
back
to
the game.
Yeah, fuck it. We're talking goat, man. That's serious shit. But, 85,000 green dice that I roll. And, of course, I dodged the fuck out of everything.
Wow, yeah.
Luckily, I actually rolled enough green dice. If I get to roll enough green dice, it's like rolling zero green dice, in that it all balances out. I'll roll what I need.
So
when you've got zero green dice, you roll what you need.
So Brian's A-wing actually did more damage than his ghost,
sure
which
did.
Is interesting.
I don't like moving fire control system target lock to the A-wing there. I should have left it on the other ghost.
Yeah, I don't think it mattered.
Well, it
doesn't matter at all, because what I do next. Because what I thought here was that I was going to sprint out the... I was going to sprint the A-wing out and do some damage, but I wasn't thinking about snapshot, which you'll find out. Remember what happens when Parker rolls green dice? Parker fails hard. So total failboat.
All right. Well, let's see.
Because again, I'm thinking that so I'm gonna lose a stress, or I'm gonna gain a stress and lose a stress. It's all gonna kind of swap out here. I think I net total gain one stress by moving over the debris field because I'm making a green maneuver. Because I would have lost.
Well, you lose one, gain one, so yeah. It's just net zero.
Yeah. It's basically a net zero gain or loss. But I was sitting zero stress behind the rock. This would be where the barrel roll last turn would have been but I wouldn't have gotten the trick shot bonus to shoot that A-wing, which I honestly legit needed to kill the A-wing.
It wouldn't have mattered. You don't have barrel roll. You have
boost.
That's right. But you ran up your front end to the debris, so you couldn't boost out of it.
Yeah. So that was it.
All right, so here's a general question to you guys. When you put your dials down, I have a rule where once my dial is placed, I do not change it. Because I've multiple times.
Because you second guess yourself?
I have gone through and screwed myself out of the correct.
I'll second guess myself all day long. Yeah. No, I'm okay with that.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
No, I mean, because it's like all of a sudden I'll go, oh shit, that thing has a rear firing arm.
Yeah. I'll forget something, so I had to pick it up or change it. Or I think of something better.
It kind of depends on the situation. Like, if you forget about some sort of mechanic they have, then, yeah, you should probably change it.
Right.
But if you're just, like, thinking of, you know, you're trying to think off base. Yeah, yeah, trying to think like that. Like, right. Instead of the obvious maneuver they would do, then, you know, you probably shouldn't second guess yourself.
Right.
Hey, weird random question while we're waiting for the dials to go down here. So, does Snapshot say that it only works out the front arc?
It's a secondary weapon, so it can only work out the front,
okay,
front
arc. Because I was thinking about Snapshot on TIE SFs. For a hot minute there, but it wouldn't do you any good. I was just trying to think. There are certain things we're trying to exploit that can be used out of a primary arc and a secondary arc. So I'm trying to come up with different things that you can use the TIE SF for besides my my Wingman FCS pattern analyzer.
Dude, that's interesting.
You run a pair of those and they never get stress at all. They never stress and they always get actions.
Pattern analyzer, yeah. I like when you push the limit on them because then they just like. You push the limit, get two actions, but you push the check pilot stress step to later, so they're always unstressed, but they get two actions.
Mm-hmm.
It's great.
Sexy. Very sexy. I love it.
So, yeah, this seems kind of like this seems kind of like a important turn, right?
Yeah.
Yeah,
Parker's really thinking about that A-wing there.
Yeah, see my short little stubby arms wiggling around and my fat gut going like, arr! I feel like a T-Rex right there.
Parker's, you know, gotten back into this game with this turn. So let's see if he can, you know, keep up the
momentum?
The advantage he's gotten.
Yeah.
The answer is no. So here I thought I'm going to try and swoop in, get rid of a stress, because, again, I had what I should have done was fucking too straight, not too soft. If I'd have gone too straight, because the reason why I went too soft is that even though I know I'm parking onto a debris field, I know I'm going to get another stress. And of course, I rocked myself, so taking another fucking shield. But I was thinking that by going the too soft, I'm positioning more to where no matter where his A-wings end up, I should be able to get auto blaster shots on him.
Wow, so we got a... four or five straight off of Parker's.
It's a 5K.
5K?
Yeah, that was capital failure. Yeah, because I was thinking that his shit was going to all end up in front of me.
Yeah, so you thought they were going to, you know, fly past you.
Yeah, and then because of grade A boobities, then I think I did. I actually fit the 5K, didn't I?
No, it doesn't fit in there.
Okay, because it was real close. It was just one of those things that's like ridiculous closeness. I don't know why I rolled a hit there that I crossed the debris.
You crossed the debris that the
ghost
was hiding.
And that was a snapshot,
yeah.
I think, that killed me.
Well, yeah, I rolled the two dice up top for the snapshot.
Yep.
So it looks like you
and
take
then I get
one
a second
shield.
Snapshot, I believe.
Yeah, no, it stripped off my shield, and then I think he got his second snapshot off because I was at range one. Because I thought I was
and
thinking,
yep,
yeah, that killed me. Yeah. Seriously, there was that one move, that 5K. I was thinking about a 3K, but I didn't quite know where his shit was going to end up because I thought that if I 5K'd, I would park right beside the ghost, and I was literally off by about a 16th or an 8th of an inch. And the 5K was literally off by just that much.
Oh, man, that's rough.
And like I said, right back out of the game again. Although now it's one ghost, and I'm sitting there going, Mongo likey.
And Brian's ghost isn't the best position for you to be in, Parker.
Sure, but then like he flies his A-wings up and they go, excuse me.
Hi.
Well, looks this A-Wing was not going to have a shot on you, it looks like. So this isn't actually not that bad.
Yeah, this isn't a terrible maneuver. I mean, he's got auto blaster shots on me, but, I mean, other than that, it's not too terrible.
Oh, yeah.
Like, and then he bumped. It was kind of ridiculous. See, again, my 5K was the great move there if no snapshot and if that ghost was a smidgey off.
I don't understand why it's good. You would still be facing the wrong way.
No, but you see, I'm lined up now for the pursuit move.
And the next round, he was behind you.
And I'd have a back shot on the ghost.
Next round, he can two-hard and be behind your A-Wings.
Right, but while he's not going to be that big, I'm going to K-turn as well.
But the other point, though,
see,
is that...
See, the reason... I think you got stuck on your 3Ks and your 5Ks mm-hmm. as being good moves. I think you just could have just gone two forward.
Possibly. Yeah.
Two forward would have been better. You would have been facing me, and the only way I would be behind you is if I flew too far over
see,
you.
See, honestly, I think what I was expecting you to do was not turn into this corner of the board, but instead to shoot straight across. And that's why I got the idea that 5 would have been good. But still, I mean, a 5K would have still given me shots on that ghost. I would have had two ships on that ghost. And the ghost isn't returning fire except for the auto blaster.
Looks like we see an accuracy corrector coming in.
Yeah, I had to accuracy correct a primary weapon shot.
Five dice.
Sure did. Welcome to my dice. I felt real bad, man.
Looks like we got auto blaster turret coming back.
Yeah, and I think I just sucked it right in the face. And this is the game where it's pretty much, this is me pointing out, going, and this is where I fail. And yeah, bad moves. Bad moves, Johnny. Bibbidi bobbidi, bobbidi boobidi. If only I could do this, then I could do that. And just do real bad.
All right, so shields down on your ghost, Parker.
Yeah, it's pretty much all over but the shouting now. I mean, it's just a simple matter. If you can
see,
you
still got 10 hull.
Yeah, 10 hull and not even 8 minutes left of this game. Why don't you tell me how it's going to end? So we're trying to maneuver. I'm trying to come up with anything I really can from here. I'm sitting on, I think, one stress. His ghost is double stressed. But his ghost doesn't care, again, because of Hera Chopper.
Yeah.
And he's already got the FCS thrown over onto me. So he could just 5K focus, and then he's sitting on a focus target.
All the ships can 5K now, and have you and Ark.
I don't think they can, because the two wings are bumped at each other at an angle.
I see.
So I think one of them's like a 3K, and one's like a 5, yeah.
It still works. And Parker has to move first, so he's probably going to end up bumping something.
Yeah. I think I may have tried to slip like a too soft the other way just to try and slip around and line me up for the 5K next turn, I think was my plan.
Yeah, I almost would have tried to do like a
one straight bump.
Or some sort of hard turn just to get a little bit of distance from the 5Ks that you expect to be coming up. And the next round you can 5K and start jousting again.
The problem is I'm stressed. I have to clear the stress.
Oh, right.
No hard turn.
No Hera, yeah.
And was that the ship that got the damage? Oh, because I think that the other ghost ended up with the hard turn, the hard turn red crit.
Oh, that's rough.
Yeah, so I mean, it was kind of like that meant that my two hards, so therefore 1, 2, and 3 hards are all red. It's like it's a no maneuverability at all. Yeah, and that 5K right there was damnably close. It was real close. It had about a quarter inch to go, so it was good maneuvering.
I was in the middle of the board. It's fine.
Yeah,
didn't even have to look at it.
Shut up. I have
confidence.
At the when I played in the Guard Tower Store Championship, the way that both of my last two games ended was a 5K and ending up about a 16th of an inch off the board edge. But when you're facing down Soontir Fell, who has literally tabled your entire list, and it's just him and a ghost left, what do you do, man?
Well, Fell doesn't like Autoblaster turrets.
But I was running TLT turrets at that point.
That's
TLT.
Rough. That's way worse.
Accurate TLT ain't bad, though. Yeah. You have enough room for a Z95. But.
Yeah, but against an auto-thruster ship, it's not going to do anything.
Mm-hmm. Looks like the Parker started to take damage from the A-Wings there.
Oh, yeah. I was just getting shit on. And then, like, I tried to fly around and just... We can practically end it here, because what's going to happen is that I'm trying to fly away and remaneuver, and he's just hunting me down and killing me. So I mean, it's all over but the shot in here.
This is why I would have liked like a two hard maybe. So you're a little bit further away from Brian's ships, but the next round you can 5K and get shots back.
No, I can't 5K because I'm stressed.
Oh, you're stressed. That's right.
So I could have at that point two softed and then 5K'd.
That's right. But that's why I did the two soft.
But you'll notice that I'm stressed up to hell and back because he's throwing stress down on me with...
And one of the crits I got was to give you a stress. So
yeah,
that
didn't help. It's just there's I mean, literally, I was doomed at this point. And this is the point where my hard turned into stress.
Oh, God.
So literally, I mean, it's done. It's completely and totally done.
I feel like you just have to run Hera on these ghosts.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It makes just 5K every turn, or at least the threat of 5K every turn makes them so
especially
much
good if you run them with debris.
Yeah. It's one of those things where I think that...
you basically ignore obstacles.
I mean, I love the double ghost list. I really legit love a good double ghost. But at the same time, I'm feeling like that one ghost geared up like Brian's, a 40-point ghost with FCS, Hera Chopper Crew, and Auto Blaster Turret. I mean, it's a big, nasty 40-point ship that you can use as the anchor for the rest of your fleet.
Yeah, so how do you feel about replacing an accuracy corrector with FCS plus Hera?
I would definitely, if I was flying this exact list again, I would 100% do that. So I would have one accurate auto blaster, one FCS Hera Chopper auto blaster.
Yeah, it seems good.
Because at that point, then I've got some accuracy. Then I have the I don't give a shit what you do list. Because then I've got the 40-point ship that just kind of goes, okay, well, I'm just going to fly it like a big fat X-Wing. A big fat X-Wing that eats stress like Jack Porkins, and it works out great.
And we have these A-Wings just getting up behind the ghost.
Yeah, and then it's like I said, he's just hunting me down. And I'm trying to reposition to where I can clear some stress, K-turn around, and at least give it a final shot. But
right.
The A-Wing's just nipping at my heels.
Yeah, and Brian's doing a good job here staying at range 2 to 3.
Yeah, there's nothing I can do
outside
about
of that auto-blaster sure. range.
Just nothing I can do.
Not going to let any of his A-Wings die for the auto-blaster turret.
No. Yeah, so, I mean, honestly, you could stop it at any point. I mean, that's basically the whole point of the game. So, going forward, I think that if I was to redesign this particular list, I would build one exactly like Brian's is. But I like another earlier iteration. Instead of the A-Wing, where I run Blunt with Ion Pulse Missiles, and I think Trick Shot. Because at that point, then, Blunt basically, so after he fires his Ion Pulse, something's going to go one forward next turn, you know? So Blunt gives you the slap of Ion in the face hole, and then at that point on, he's just a Z95 with Trick Shot.
Yeah, and depending on, you know, what you're Ioning, you can either set up a really nice 5-dice primary for next round,
or a pair of accurate
auto blasters, yeah.
Yeah, it feels better that way. But yes, that's it. So I wanted to thank everybody coming. Thanks, Brian, for the ass whipping that you gave me.
You're welcome. Anytime.
Felt really hot and bothersome. I mean, it may have actually given me the hernia that I have now, so I'm pretty impressed. So that was a delayed reaction hernia. You know, I felt it so hard later that all of a sudden my guts decided to go, shuriken, and then escape my body.
Yep.
But no, thank you all very much for taking a listen to our Central Ohio X-Wing Raven Squadron video commentary extravaganza. This is LB signing off. Say bye, Brian.
Bye, Brian.
Excellent, Brian. Way to go. Say bye, Husson.
Bye, Husson.
And, of course, say bye, Dave.
Bye, Dave.
And that'll take care of it. Thank you all. Have yourselves a fantastic rest of your day. And blow up something.